Well, 100 subs is pretty crazy. When I hit that number on New Year's Eve, I had to sit to myself and think, damn, that's a lot of people. I've deadass accumulated a small preschool of subs. God, I'm going to fucking jail. I need to stop this shit. What is wrong? Anyway, since I've reached this milestone, I want to do something a little special for the occasion. So I'm going to be hosting a Q&A. Yes, I know, very original. I'm definitely not opting out for the easiest choice here. And while yes, some would consider 100 subs very small, after 2 years on this channel, it still means a lot to me. So if you have any questions you would like to ask me, feel free to comment down below. And at the end of the next video, I'll do my best to answer as many as I can. With all that said, let's get down to business here. Now the original plan here was to do both Silver Chariot and Silver Chariot Requiem in the same video, but after remembering the shit ton of work I had to do with gold experience, I decided I'd rather keep the minuscule amount of brain cells I have left and just split the video into two separate ones. So for today, I'm going to be covering Silver Chariot and I'll tackle SCR in the next video. Now, unless you have the intelligence equivalent to the average Spurg in a random YBA lobby, you should easily figure out how to get Silver Chariot, so I'm not going to focus on that point too much. With that said, let's move on to the skill tree and moveset for Silver Chariot. Silver Chariot costs a low 39 skill points to fully max out. So this is one of the rare times where I would recommend for you to max out, cause if you don't, you look like a clown. This stand has a total of 4 unlockable moves that you can use, and while yes, this is a very low amount of moves for a stand to have, you'll see in a moment why that literally doesn't fucking matter whatsoever. So to show why that's the case, let's take a quick look over at the default moves here. For a stand that is lacking in the number of moves at its disposal, it definitely makes up for it by having a fast stand speed and pretty decent damage output. And while these numbers are far from the best in game, I can't overstate just how strong they are as well. For our first unlockable move, we're starting off with one of the most useful, Shed Armor. This move, after a brief animation, gives you a major amount of speed when you throw out your moves. While I don't know the specifics of just how much faster you move than normal, just by seeing the footage, you can easily tell just how fucking fast you are going. The main reason I would consider this the most useful move in this kit is solely because when your moves lands at damn near 5x speeds, that results in a shit ton more damage than normal. And if you're doing more damage, you're putting a shit ton more pressure on whoever you're fighting. And if you combine the damage you can deal with your stand speeds increased, plus whatever spec you're running, then you essentially turn yourself into a cyclone of pain and fuckery. Speaking of cyclones, next here we have Cycle Slash. This move sends out a cyclone of hits that each deal 5.3 damage and can be very lethal when used in rapid succession. And with this move being an AoE, this makes situations where you're getting jumped from all 360 degrees a lot more manageable. While this move can be both blocked and cancelled, I would still say it's a pretty balanced trade-off to having extra security from all given directions. So all in all, I like the move and it's very fun to watch. Next here we have Million Pricks. This is fairly straightforward. You land this move and send a crazy amount of hits that each deal 0.7 damage, which I know is small, but that shit easily stacks up. One thing you should know about this move is that the hitbox is slightly janky from time to time. You'll sometimes find yourself in a position where you think you've landed a hit, but the game decides to phase through the fucking opponent. But this is very rare, and if you have issues consistently with it, you are very unlucky, my guy. Also, another side tip here, for the first few seconds of this move, your opponent will be able to block the initial flurry of hits, so don't get caught off guard too much here. And also, a little fun fact, for some reason, you can stack this move nearly indefinitely on the NPCs, and once you activate them, it released all that stacked up potential and hits all at once. I've seen a lot of people use this to farm bosses, and me personally, I used it to needlessly farm Jotaro discs for shits and giggles. I'm not sure if the stack is intentional or a glitch, but for the time being, it's a pretty fun anomaly. Finally, we have, ironically enough, Last Shot. This move shoots off your rapier and lets it ricochet off surrounding objects until it hits the closest target for 12 damage. While this move isn't too powerful, I will admit that if you're trying to get in some quick stun and or chip damage, this move will definitely help you achieve that goal. And seeing that the move is cancelable but unblockable, I'd say it's a pretty reliable way of catching your opponent off guard. Silver Chariot is by far some of the most fun I've had playing a stand in this game. And while I still get shat on by base star platinum players because I'm just shit at the game, it's hard to say I didn't enjoy playing around with it and just goofing off with it in main game. Hell, I've been using Silver Chariot as a secondary main for the last 4 months. This stand is, just like many others, heavily underrated, or at least to me, it seems like it is. It just seems like there are less and less Silver Chariot players almost every day. Whether or not that's a direct result of the next evolution of it being a shit ton more powerful is, nah, that's exactly the case, bruh. Overall, I still consider Silver Chariot a shit ton of fun, and I love it. And for that, I'll give Silver Chariot a solid 9 out of 10, and I'm proud to say that unapologetically. Suck my dick. While this is one of my shorter videos, I'm still pretty proud of how this one came out. While I do have my little bits of fun making longer videos, I think I'm going to try making them a little less rambly and a bit more compact for the sake of me and you guys' time. Though what I'm saying here could easily be wrong, seeing the next video is fucking Silver Chariot Requiem, so we'll have to see. Until then, thanks for your time. Thanks for the 100 subs. And hopefully I'll have some questions to answer in the next video. Or not, I don't know. Am I? Oh shit, I'm rambling again, aren't I? Oh god. God fucking...